Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nataraj and I'm a faculty member at TAPME. I welcome you all to the 7th Leadership Lecture Series of TAPME Silver Jubilee Silver Series. I shall be taking you through this function today. I request our chief guest, Dr. Harish Hande, Magsaysay Award winner and Managing Director of Selco Solar Light, Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro-Chancellor, Manipal University and a member of TAPME's Governing Council, and Dr. Shantaram, member of TAPME Trust and Governing Council, to please come on the stage and light the lamp. Professor Vasudev Rao, Director in Charge, and Professor Chaudhary Prasad will accompany the dignitaries. Ms. Neha Gaud will present the bouquet to Dr. H.S. Ballal. Ms. Isha Pandey will present the bouquet to Dr. Shantaram. Thank you, ladies. I request our Director in Charge, Dr. Vasudev Rao, to welcome the gathering.
Respected Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro-Chancellor of Manipal University and member of our Governing Council and Trustee. Dr. Harish Hande, Founder, Member and Managing Director of Selco and distinguished speaker of today's Leadership Lecture 2011. Dr. H. Shantaram, our member of Governing Council and Trustee. Professor Chaudhary Prasad, Dean Planning and Development. Heads of Institutes of Manipal Group and faculty members and invitees, faculty and staff of us and our students, members of media, ladies and gentlemen. I have great pleasure in welcoming you all to this leadership lecture series, this is the 7th one in the current year. I would like to cordially welcome Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro-Chancellor of Manipal University and our member of Governing Council and Trustee, who has kindly agreed to preside over today's program. Sir, you have been immensely supporting and guiding the various activities and development plans of TAPME. Welcome you, sir. Our chief guest, Dr. Harish Hande, has accepted our invitation to deliver the 7th leadership lecture today. It is an honor for all of us that despite his busy schedule, he accepted at very short response time to deliver the leadership lecture today on the topic of social entrepreneurship, sustainable energy, and the youth. He has demonstrated a live model of social enterprise, and this is a very apt topic looking at the developmental issues of our country. We extend him a very cordial welcome to Manipal. I cordially welcome Dr. Shantaram, our Governing Council member and trustee. I welcome you all who are eagerly awaiting to hear the leadership lecture by Dr. Hande. As you may be aware, TAPMI was set up in the early 1980s by the visionary leader Padma Bhushan Sri Tonse Anand Pai. The institute completed 25 years of its existence in 2009, and to commemorate this landmark achievement, we had started a leadership lecture series wherein thought leaders and visionary persons from different sections of society share their vision, expertise and achievements with members of TAPMI and other Manipal institutions to inspire them to take leadership roles in quest for building a great nation. Sri Salman Khurshid, the then Minister of State Corporate Affairs and Ministry Minority Affairs, Sri Rajdeep Sardesai, leading media journalist, Sri Manish Sabharwal, CEO of Team Lees, and recently His Excellency Sri M.K. Narayanan, Governor of West Bengal, Padma Shri Dr. B.R. Shetty, Managing Director and CEO of New Medical Center Abu Dhabi, UAE, Srimati Nirupama Rao, Foreign Secretary, Minister of External Affairs, on the theme India's Foreign Policy, Dilemmas, Challenges and Action, had delivered the previous lectures in this series. While previous lectures in this series were on varied topics of interest on social and political issues, during the current year, we would like to focus more on sustainability, socio-economic growth issues, and other developmental topics of importance. As you may be aware, TAPMI is consistently rated among the top 1% of the over 3,800 B schools in India, and is accredited by National Board of Accreditation, that is MBA. TAPMI is in the final stage of accreditation by International Accreditation Body of AACSB. Recently, CRISIL, the rating agency, has graded the PGDM program of TAPMI at A3 star at national and state level, and we have other achievements also during the current year. Today's leadership lecture is by a renowned person in the field of solar energy, Dr. Harish Hande, who has been awarded Raman Magsaysay Award 2011 for his pioneering work in taking solar energy to the poor through a sustainable business model. He is a true champion of underprivileged and the solar lighting and founder of and MD of Solar Electrical Lighting Company, Selco. Dr. Hande, most importantly, hails from this very district of Udupi, but his mission is to tap the solar energy abundantly available in most part of our country and perhaps wherever sun rays reach over this planet. This is why TAPMI deems it as an honor to felicitate Dr. Hande today. He will be formally introduced shortly. Dr. K. Mudupa, closely associated with Selco, and Dr. Hande is also amidst us. We welcome you, sir. I once again welcome you all to the leadership lecture by Dr. Harish Hande on social entrepreneurship, sustainable energy and the youth. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rao. I must emphasize a special aspect about two personalities on the dais today. Though TAPMI is not a part of Manipal University directly, the support we get from it in the form of facilities, benefits, and linkages are immense. Much more importantly, we have a very fatherly personality at Manipal University who provides us constant support, encouragement, and advice whenever we need it. His playing such a supporting role has enabled us to scale new heights from time to time and has given us the confidence to face fresh challenges that lie ahead. You might have guessed it by this time whom I'm talking about, Dr. H.S. Ballal, the Pro-Chancellor of Manipal University. Sir, your presence in this function has augmented its value much more. Similarly, Dr. H. Shantaram, a very busy person, a member of our trust and also our governing council, has been a source of great strength in offering support and guidance from time to time. I request Dr. Shantaram to say a few words on this occasion, sir, please.
Dr. Harish Hande and all my friends on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, all of us have assembled here to listen what Dr. Hande wants to tell us. At this juncture, I have certainly no intention to inflict a speech, except to say that today's speaker is one amongst us. When I say that thing, he is a proud son of this coastal Karnataka, and I still remember the very old days when he visited Manipal. Those were the very early days when solar energy was not very much in vogue. At that particular time he came here and told us how this particular energy can change the picture. Those were the prophetic words, I must say. Today, the solar energy has gained so much of use, practically it is competing with the electrical energy. Almost every gadget that we are going to use in the houses with the help of the electrical energy are operated by the solar energy also. So more and more in this part of the country where there is so much of sunshine, it is being harnessed. All the credit certainly goes to Dr. Hande, because in the early days people had a sort of a doubt in their mind that what will happen for the solar lights and other gadgets in the monsoon season. Our personal experience shows today that it is not so much as the sunshine, but it is the intensity of the light. Even when the sunlight is not there and we can see in our houses, the battery is being charged even after the sunset for about an hour or so, as long as there is a light. So it is a precious thing. And one other thing I must stress here, perhaps in this particular series, today's speaker is one of the youngest person, which clearly shows that it is not the age, but the acumen of the person and his devotion for the cause and his belief. Even from the beginning, Dr. Hande believed in this particular task, and today he has ascended to that pinnacle. So with these words I would like to say, all of us are very keen to hear Dr. Hande on this particular aspect of the energy. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request my colleague, Professor Chaudhary Prasad, to introduce the chief guest of the day to the audience.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my proud privilege to introduce today's chief guest, Dr. Hande. Dr. Harish Hande was born in 102 village, Kundapur Taluk, Udupi district of Karnataka. When Dr. Shantaram referred him as a very young man, he's just 43. For the last 17 years, he has been in this field. Dr. Hande is the founder and managing director of Selco India, a social enterprise established in 1995 to provide affordable renewable energy services to the poor and undeserved households in rural India. Selco, known for its customized product, doorstep financing, and doorstep service, has installed solar home lighting systems in over 1,25,000 households across Karnataka, Kerala, and Gujarat. In partnership with regional rural banks, cooperative banks, and microfinance institutions, Selco continues to innovate appropriate financial mechanisms to bridge the gap between energy needs and affordability. Selco has 25 service centers across the three states and a dedicated workforce of 180 people working round the clock to ensure that darkness is removed by reliable solar lights in poor households. Harish, a graduate from the Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur, and a master's and PhD from University of Massachusetts, US, returned to India to start Selco in 1994-95 after experiencing benefits of solar energy in rural areas of Dominion Republic and Sri Lanka. Having installed the first 1,000 home lighting systems on his own and over 125,000 households now through his company Selco India, Harish is recognized as a pioneer of rural energy service across the globe. He and his company have received many national and international awards, including the Ashden Awards twice in 2005 and 2007, the Tech Museum Award in 2005, Chemka Social Entrepreneur of the Year Award in 2007, and the Financial Times ArcelorMittal Boldness in Business Award in 2009. Harish was also one of these 21 CEOs invited to meet the US President Barack Obama during his visit to Mumbai during 2009. In 2008, Harish Hande was chosen by Business Today as one of the 21 young leaders for India's 21st century. In mid-2008, India Today named him one of the 50 pioneers of change in India. Harish won prestigious Raman Magsaysay Award, which was awarded on him on the last 31st August, 1 week back in Manila, also sometimes referred to as the Asia's Nobel Prize for his pioneering work in taking solar energy to the poor through a sustainable business model. I welcome him here. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Prasad. It's indeed a matter of pride for all of us that a person born in this part of the country has received such a coveted award, the Raman Magsaysay Award. To express our happiness about this achievement, Dr. Hande, we wish to felicitate you in a small way. I request Dr. H.S. Ballal to felicitate the chief guest with a shawl. I also request Dr. Shantaram to felicitate with a garland. And a small gift by Dr. Ballal, please. Thank you, sirs.
Mr. Udupa and friends, it's an honor to speak here. I know it's a dangerous territory for me whenever, if you heard me speak elsewhere, I always made jokes on MBAs. And this is a dangerous territory always, and I kept looking for jokes on engineers to speak to this audience, but unfortunately, I had a bias. I could not find any jokes on engineers. I'm just kidding. The topic being social entrepreneurship, sustainable energy, and the youth. Just to give you a background, right? We are in a very pampered cocoon called Manipal. We are, many of you here, everybody have come from privileged backgrounds. We enjoy the benefits of life. Take it for granted in many ways. We are very happy that India is growing at 8 to 9%. We're very thrilled that it's the second largest growing economy in the world. Well, is that reality? Is that the truth of what we are? In 2001, I mean, it's after 65 years of independence, a small statistics that 45% of Indians, fellow Indians, do not have electricity. This is a 2011, right? 65 years after independence, after 135 years that Thomas Alva Edison invented the light bulb, that 47 to 48% of the Indians do not have electricity. That's reality. And 60% of Indians still use one technology that has survived the Iron Age. That's the three-stone cooker. You put three stones and cook. That is the 65% of Indians still cook. Anyhow, 1 million Indians, 1 million citizens in the world die because of indoor air pollution. And out of that, 3/4 are Indians. On one hand, we say we are growing at 8 to 9%. On one hand, we say we are the second largest growing economy in the world. And on the other hand, we have this stark difference of other India, which is an equal responsibility of you and me, right? So to start a little more controversially, I would say, when you, the ego of graduating from IIT, right? I mean, IITians have tend to be very egoistic in many manners. And just to give you an example, when I went to IIT, I paid 60 rupees a semester